I'm going to try and timestamp all of this video into sections. If I can't get it to work, I'm going to put captions in the top corner and keep it stuck there so you can skip to the bit you want to watch. There's Meander Meander, there's ASDA, there is trying Subway after about 5 years, and an ASDA food haul of what I actually bought at ASDA.
Ooh, lovely. Minus 0.1 degrees C. I'm on a Meander Meander to ASDA. Is this the road to DisASDA? Good morning, everybody. I love how these coloured houses have all got a garland on the doors. There's going to be one, though, that hasn't. I wonder if it's going to be the one house that's painted white that doesn't have a garland. Anyway, I've decided to go to ASDA in Park Royal because of reasons. Oh, there we go, look. The first two, four, six houses had a garland on the door, and these ones don't. That's a shame. I love these houses. I've mentioned them a few times on my Meander Meander videos. And, oh look, we're back to normal. And the one painted white does have a, well, it's not a garland as such, it's just a branch. Yeah, nearly all of them had a garland. There is a reason I'm going to ASDA. Ever since it got took over, I've been a bit wary of the new owners because it feels a bit like they're asset stripping. They've even spoken of selling... Oh my word! Look at that! I didn't realise people still had milk delivered like that. That is so cute. And obviously very environmental as well. Yeah, ever since ASDA got took over, it feels as if they've been they're going to get asset stripped. And there's even been talk of selling off George, which is the... George, I suppose, is the supermarket brand that started buying clothes from a supermarket being acceptable. The man who designed the range when it first started was also one of the designers at Next, you see. It made it acceptable to buy clothes from a supermarket. And for ASDA to even consider, well, the owners of ASDA, considering selling that off is just absolutely absurd. And then they're even thinking of selling off distribution. How does a supermarket sell off distribution? That's real scorched earth right there. It's very, very worrying. And it's... Oh, that's pretty. Well, anyway, that's what I'm doing. I'm on a Meander Meander. I'm going all the way out to ASDA. And hopefully it won't be a DisASDA. There is a reason why I'm going there, other than just have a nosy about, because it is a bit out of my way. But it's the only place I can think of where I can buy throws right now. I'm hoping that... Look how frosty it is. It is 0 degrees, after all. And... Yeah, because rather than flicking the heating on, obviously, I'm quite happy to walk around with no coat on. I don't do coats. But if it does get a bit nippy, it's just nicer just to wrap a throw around you rather than flicking on the heating every 2 seconds. I need to get on the Piccadilly line. Daily, and to get on the daily, I'm gonna have to go to Ravenscourt Park and get on the District Line, which is not engine number 9 on the North Transatlantic Line at all. It's somewhere that I don't really go to very often because, as you'll see, it's a bit of a faff to get to as a pedestrian, and it's not the easiest place to get to. I'll get a few things for some review videos. But mostly I'm going there for a look around ASDA Park Royal. I'm going to the Park Royal one. I'm going for a look around and to specifically buy some throws and some food. I do need to get a few bits and bobs, so I've brought the suitcase. I'm not jugging it behind me, that's why you don't hear it going behind me, because otherwise it's very loud. These things just really annoy me, just left around.
And I'm in the waiting box room again.
Oh. Service update for the dish bag. Due to bad engineering works, there is no service on the dish bag between Tinnan Green to Eland Broadway. Passengers for Eland Broadway to take the Richmond train to Gunnersbury and change for the rail replacement bus service.
See, this is why you should check before you travel, isn't it? Flipping heck. I need to get on the Piccadilly. And I think I need to get on there at... Does it stop at Turnham Green?
As Adina Monsoon once said, sometimes you've got to go backwards before you can move forwards, which is exactly what I'm going to have to do. I'm going to get the tube to Hammersmith just to come all the way back to get to Park Royal. How annoying. So I've got to go down these stairs. Around. And up these ones. Well, that was a bit blurred. Why is my camera blurred? What's going on? Got focus yet? Oh no, it's got focus. Maybe my phone doesn't like sub-zero temperatures. I don't know. What's that that's falling off? That's a 2 meter clear sign. I was once there. And now I'm here. So I'm going west by first going east. Oh, please don't tell me I've got to wait ages. 5 minutes, that's now. And if I miss it, there's one in another minute. Oh, that was lucky. Very lucky. Carriage to myself for about 5 seconds. Looks as if they've recovered the seats on this train. Looks very new. It's very vibrant. And it was too good to be true. I'm on the wrong bloody one. I have to get off the nice, newly covered seats Piccadilly Line train. Well. Well, that's annoying. I thought I could go east to go west, and it turns out that I can't, because at Ravenscourt Park Station it failed to mention, but there was no Piccadilly Line service there. Now I've got to go south to go west, which means getting on the Piccadilly Line, I think. That's going the wrong way, that one. So I can't get that one either. I've got to go to Gunnersbury Park and there's a replacement bus service. Oh, of course, because it's still a bank holiday, isn't it? That's probably why. Oh, well. Was there, met Matt there, now I've got to go down there to go somewhere. Yeah. Yeah, when it's a bank holiday, you should always check before you travel. I could have walked to you and got the replacement bus for free. Never mind, it's one of them things. Oh, there it is now. Hopefully, this is the right one. Nope, I have to wait for the next one. Right, I think I shall be opening the window. It's weird, this bus. It's weird seeing different seats. Oh, it's an adventure. I love getting rail replacement buses because they go really random places, down new roads and all sorts. That's the B&Q that I normally go to, where I play with the doorbells. That was one of the really oppressive security guard who was wondering why I was filming so much. I wouldn't know, there was a graveyard right behind it. It's quite a major one as well. See what I mean? The things you notice and the things you see. For anyone outside of London, yeah, the rail replacement buses are free. And when you get on them, they only stop at the tube stations. Very rarely there'll be a extra pickup point, but very rarely. And you'll get a conductor telling you that the you're at the station, because obviously sometimes the bus stop isn't quite directly outside of the station.
Piccadilly Line Rail Replacement Service to Rainers Lane Station.
Ealing Common. Over there, that's where the house for Gimme 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 is. Look at him. In a ragged. That'd be so funny. I think one of the benefits of not driving is that if I did drive, I'd always be at the Maccadies 24 hours. And I'd get incredibly obese. I just know I would. Gross, horrible tower block buildings getting built. I bet they'll cost a fortune as well when they get ready to be sold. Although, because it has to keep to a certain time, it does mean that sometimes the rail replacement bus can drive very slowly. I think a snail's just rushed by. Oh, and here comes a tortoise. Oh, do you know, I'd love some fish and chips right now.
Piccadilly Line Rail Replacement Service to Rainers Lane Station.
I've got a strange feeling. I've been too busy looking out the window and missed Park Royal. Oh no. I am such an idiot if I have. It can't be this long. The next station's South Arrow. Have I missed my stop? Oh no, I have. I've been so busy looking out the window. I was in a daydream and I've completely missed my stop by about 3 stops. I am such a moron. Oh, I am such an idiot because it's just so nice and calm. I've missed my stop. Oh no, what a geek. I'm going to have to go downstairs and the bus driver was so nice. I am such an idiot. As if I've missed it by 3 stops. See, it doesn't matter if you plan your journey, I'm still flipping getting off at the wrong stop. Oh no. This is absolutely hilarious. Right. Meant to be going to ASDA, and this journey is turning out to be a disaster because not only did I miss my stop 3 stops ago, now they're having trouble getting this bus even moving because the door won't shut. Oh, please go now. Please go. Please. Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. Yes! Oh. We're moving. And we're stopping. Still chuckling to myself. I'm so dopey. There's that chippy again. It's now nearly 11:30. The seats on this bus are so uncomfy. The bus seats are so hard. I've sat on rocks at the beach that have been comfier than these seats. And it's quite a bouncy bus journey as well, this one. Obviously, I needn't have even been on it. I'd have been paying attention, but... There's a place around here called One Tree Hill. It reminded me of One Tree Field, if you remember from back in the day, with Solomon. God. Everyone's so nice. The bus driver lady gave me directions to ASDA, and I'm hoping that I do it right. Now this I've definitely seen before. That's I think they're helicopters. I think. Oh, this is very 1960s, isn't it? Wonder if it is 1960s or if it was just made to look at. I don't know what these are meant to be. And she says, go this way. I hope I've got this right. Look, this is like a roundabout for people. I love the echoes. And I love all the coloured tiles. With big cobwebs. And yeah. This way, I believe. I'll see when I go out. It's hard to tell when you're underground. It was the other way. Yes, it was the other way. I thought instead of getting the bus for a couple of bus stops, I thought I'd just walk. And for the bus stops, well, that went well, didn't it? Look at this. It's a bus stop, and I think, well, something's definitely stopped. I can't even see the... I need to know if I'm going the right way. Am I going the right way? Am I going the right way? I think so. We'll just pop that back where it was. I was gonna get a trolley and fix the phone to it. I've just got here, after all that palaver, I've got on the tripod to hold the phone. Oh well, not gonna get anything frozen. Might as well just... What have I come here for now? Forgotten. Well, just when you think there's enough of Oreo for everything, Oreos. Oreos cereal. A playful twist, exclamation mark. And of course, for some reason, they've put the exclamation mark on for new. Oh, how much are them? We don't know, because the price ticket is missing. That is not helpful at all, is it? Oh well. That's going to be a review for tomorrow, probably.
Alright.
It is quite busy in here today, actually. I'm going to see if the cheapest coffee can come out tasting delicious in the Velvetizer. Because Tesco have stopped doing their value stuff, but there's ASDA Smart Price still going, which is great. 70p.
for 100 gram of coffee. That is incredibly cheap. I'm sure it used to be cheaper though. I hate this nonsense what Asda and Sainsbury's have started doing, and you know, just piling it high like this. It looks so awful. Being reduced to 37p. Might as well get a bag, see what they're like. Asda turkey and stuffing and cooked crisps. Has it been hand stuffed as well, the turkey, before there was tended to crisps? We don't know. No idea how much they've been reduced to, but I thought I'd get a couple. These are new and look nice. Yeah, let's give them a go. Ho ho ho, green giants. Thought I'd get some sweet corn. I love sweet corn. I didn't know they did a salt-free version, but I got the original. Because, do you know what? I'm yet to buy a can of sweet corn that is actually as good as green giant. It is really nice. All the JML tat. Oh, God, I've got two screens playing at the same time. Three screens playing at the same time. It's just too much. All you can hear is being shouted at by screens. Flipping heck. I used to always buy my CDs from Asda. Well, not always, but I bought a lot of CDs from Asda back in the day. don't anymore. Oh, they're selling vinyl records. that's annoying, actually. No wonder. It's just typical supermarkets, isn't it? Just sell everything, but with no particular style. I'm still trying to plug the Polaroid brand. CD boombox. That is not a boombox. That is terrible. Oh, of course, it's been such a long time since I've seen the On brand. This is the ASDA branded stuff. Look, it's even got ASDA on the box, that little radio there, look. FM ASDA. FM ASDA. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know what it's about supermarkets, you know, when they don't really specialise in it, they just sell it because they know people will want it. And look, the TV's just thrown in like that. Oh, Crash Bandicoot. I think Crash Bandicoot's got to be the best mascot for PlayStation. Unofficial, obviously, because it wasn't made by Sony, was it, Crash Bandicoot? As if they're going to try and sell off George. I remember now. I was wanting to come in here for the throws, weren't I? And I don't think I'm going to find what I want in here, though, because it's all going to be polyester. And it's always best to get cotton throws, really. And these are all polyester. The way how some people shop just infuriates me. Why do people need to tear into a pillow like that? Why? What are they going to gain from doing that? What a waste. Oh, it just drives me up the wall. And they've also done it with a duvet up here, look. There's no way I'd want to buy them now. But someone's dating filthy hands all over it.
Oh, is it soft? I don't believe it. Let's rive it open, shall we?
Let's just rive everything up. Look, look. Really makes me angry.
Oh, look at that cute little cloud lamp. Cloud. Yeah, there's no throws in here that are going to be good enough. Oh, they're all duvet sets. Never mind. Never mind. Do need to get some bananas. Not very big though, these ones, are they? They're quite yellow. I'm trying to eat a banana a day for the potassium, and they're a bit greener. Oh yeah, that is lots of bananas, but I'm eating one a day, so that's quite, I think that's normal. Yeah, I don't know what's going on with ASDA. I mean, why would you put soft sliced baguettes right next to bananas? I mean, what are they thinking? I know it's impulse buying and whatnot, but that's just weird and stupid. What, you're gonna have a banana baguette? I've just decided to get some stupid bleach. I prefer stupid bleach, it lasts longer. Yes. I think I'm nearly done actually. I don't need to get anything more. Windoline! Just use vinegar. I love the bakery section. Thing is though, I get really hungry because the smell of fresh bread being, well, that's old bread there, but the smell of fresh bread is I love this smell in it, and yes. That big massive jars of Nutella. The thing is about Nutella though, I love it, and then I go right off it for ages. Caramel latte. I can make my own now. Don't need to pay $3.99. Just ram it in the velvetizer. I missed this the first time round because I was too busy trying to find the price, but look at this. Lint spread. It's like their version of Nutella, I think. Is that in focus? It is now. Oh, there's two. There's chocolate spread and there's an hazelnut one. It's quite dear, £3.50. But it's for a review. That's a good couple of weeks worth of videos I've got here now. Just noticed these toast and jam tastes like jam on toast. There's a decaf bedtime with vanilla and nutmeg. I love the word nutmeg, I don't know why, I always think it's funny. And there's a taste like tea and biscuits and toast and jam again breakfast. Yes, so they've just doubled that up. It looks as if this one seems to be popular. Or maybe they just didn't get as much of it in. What's that? Yorkshire tea, sorry, temporarily out of stock. Yorkshire tea gold. Yeah, so they've just doubled that up because they've run out of Yorkshire tea gold. You see, this is clearly the only section you'd need. I mean, why are they wasting space with Tetley and PG? Get Yorkshire tea. If you go around to someone's house and they offer you PG, You've offended them somehow, and you need to find out what you've done. And if you go around to someone's house and they're offering you Tetley tea, they've been very cheap and they're not giving you respect. You get Yorkshire tea. Now, I might be slightly biased in saying that, but that is the truth. You don't need that. You don't need that. You get that. And the only reason why you get Twanins is if you're pretending to be Hyacinth Bouquet. The Bouquet residence lady of the house speaking. Oh, it looks as if you can still buy Seabrook crisps in a supermarket other than Lidl. You can't get them in Sainsbury's or Tesco, but not the ones I've been into anyway. Yeah. I still very much love crisps. Despite doing that month of eating crisps only, I do love crisps. And now that I know I can lose weight eating crisps, that's just amazing. And I'm definitely thinking of doing it again for January to lose the weight that I've put on again over Christmas and whatnot. But I'll still do Tuesday review days. Really annoying. Doritos used to do sticky barbecue or something. I can't remember what it was, but it was Summit Barbecue and it was amazing. But they seem to have discontinued it and now it's just flame grilled steak you can get, and it's not the same flavour. really annoying. Sensations. I'm not surprised they're cleared up because I love Sensations crisps. They are really popular. And some new flavours up there that are clearly not selling as much. But the sweet chilli chicken ones, is there any left? No. They are really good. I wonder if people are panic buying sweet Thai chilli crisps. And what's the other flavour that I love? Oh, the Thai chicken flavour from McCoy's. They're never in a big bag, are they? I would be absolutely amazed if I found them. Remember, don't be melancholy, everybody. Don't be melancholy, do you get it? Not even joking, there's a bloke who was just behind me just a minute ago, coughing his guts up, not even attempting to cover his mouth. The dirty, disgusting, dank, donk. Oh, where is he? I'll show you a picture of him from behind, and in that way I'm not being thinking, but it was just him, no mask on, and coughing, not covering his face or anything. Oh, it makes me feel sick, despite even what's going on at the moment. Oh, I hate people who cough like that, you know, proper hacking it up, like that, and not even covering the face. Oh, it makes you feel sick. I think I'm pretty much done now, actually. I've got everything that I need. It is really busy in here, actually, but I've got everything that I need. I've got plenty of YouTube video stuff now. And I'll have a look at the frozen stuff, but with the palaver it took me to get here, I think it'd be silly for me to buy anything frozen, because by the time I get it home, it's going to be either soup or slosh. Which is a shame, because there's quite a lot of things here that I'd love to review, but I'm just too far away. This house is just not close enough, and it is, as you can see, today was an extra special pain to get to. I'm going to go home now and show you the haul of stuff that I've got. It's not really a haul, because it's only a basket. Just a basket of stuff. I'm really hungry now looking at all of this. I'm purposely not getting any of that Lifebuoy stuff because the advert annoys me so much. You know, you're watching something quite nice and soothing on telly and all of a sudden it's that stupid Lifebuoy song. No, it's not the number one. It's not the number one at all. What are you talking about? Every time I see the ad, I feel like buying two bottles of Dettol instead. This is where I'm going to find out how much the... Oh good, there was a pound. This is where I'm going to find out how much them peanuts was. Well, they're £2.50 each. Oh no, £1.50 each. It's just adding it up at the bottom. Right. I was gonna say, yeah, I've had them taken off. Oh, oof, pressed the wrong button. £41.90, right. The lady who was working on the self-scan tills were one of them. She thought I was gonna steal the basket. She was like, you're not allowed to set the basket. I went, oh no, so I'm just putting them back in the basket so I can pack it out the way. You know, like you would at Aldi or Lidl. And, I mean, bless the cotton socks. Do you know what? I've just seen a Subway over there. And I am peckish, and I wasn't waiting in the queue in there for the little... picked up someone's rank hat on my suitcase. I'm going to have a Subway for the first time in about, 5 years? Do they still do the meatball marinara? I don't know. But yeah, I wasn't waiting in there for the kiosk queue because that's just ridiculous. Don't want to get run over. It's best to look before you cross, especially in a supermarket car park. You know what they're like. Well, I'm not going to go home the way I came. I'm going to get the bus that will be so much easier. I thought by getting the tube, I thought it was going to be a lot quicker and simpler. But obviously with it being all on rail replacement, and clearly I'm not in my right mind. Oh, I can take this off now. Just for a bit. Oh, gosh. Ladies, is that what it's like when you take a bra off? Oh, feels like I can breathe. Ooh. Ooh, fresh air. Fresh London fume-filled air. Now look, it's an old subway look because it's got the old signage on. But I'm going to give it a go. And you know what? If I feel ripped off and it fits just as I remember it, I'm never going to go there again. This is going to be make or break subway. If this particular subway at Park Royal makes me feel as if I'm ripped off or that the sandwich is not good enough, I'm never going to go to Subway again. Nothing against this particular Subway, obviously. This is just Subway in general. If it's nice, it might be another 5 years till I go back to you, but I'm going to go to Subway. I can't believe I'm saying that. A sandwich! I was going to cross over like this and I just realised that little cutting out bit there. DPD and FedEx. Ooh, the competition, the rivalry. Oh, I do love breathing in fumes. Feels so much better than my own carbon dioxide. The good thing about Subway is you don't have to wait because no one goes there anymore. I'm gonna be able to walk right in there and get my sandwich. Yes, I am. I think the shock of a customer might surprise them, don't you think? They'll be like, oh, I've got a customer! And they might be like so grateful and thankful. Do you think I'm gonna get a smile? Do you think I'm gonna get a smile? Absolutely no cure.
Ages since I've been to a Subway. Do you still do the meatball marinara?
Yeah.
Oh, lovely. I'll have a meatball marinara then, please. Pardon? Oh, yeah. I'll have it on Italian herbs and cheese, please.
Small one, big one?
Just a small one, please. I'll have cheese, yes please. I don't want it toasted though. And I'll have sweet corn and that'll be it. Cheers. Sorry? Nah, not toasted, thank you. Sweet corn, yes please. Nah, you're alright, thank you. Are you alright taking cash or do you want me to pay by card?
Sorry?
Do you want me to pay by cash or card?
Both.
Is it okay?
£4, mate.
Cheers, thank you very much. Thank you. Cheers, thank you very much.
You.
Have a nice new year. Get my sandwich. Have a good new year.
I
found the most awkward, most weirdest bench to sit on. First of all, I've got these two looking at me. What are you two looking at? No, you can't have some of my sandwich. What are you doing? And second of all, another reason why sitting here is weird. It's because you get cars flying at you. What a horrible place to sit. And also, the seat is really low down. I've got my knees stuck in my nostrils. It's such a low seat. Anyway, let's see what this subway is like.
It looks as if I brought the customers well because someone walked in behind me. This is what I'd normally get, a meatball marinara. I'm surprised they still sell it actually, I thought they might change the menu. And it doesn't look particularly warm. And the guy who worked in there was all right. Just all right, but in fact disappointing. Let me finish it, let me enjoy it, and I'll get back to you. It's not that good, and it's nothing he's done wrong. It's nothing what this particular subway has done wrong. It's got nothing to do with that. It's just not good. I forgot how sweet the bread was, and it doesn't taste. It. I know the big thing is about what is it, eat fresh or something, the slogan. But it doesn't taste it. In the sense of, it just doesn't taste like it's freshly baked at all, and that's nothing to do with him. It just tastes like a cheap piece of bread. Tomato sauce was got a strange sort of taste against the bread, and then the meatballs, there was four in there, they weren't as meaty as I remember. Have they cheapened out? If there's any long standing fans of Subway, let me know in the comment section down below. Have they changed the meatballs? Because they was not as meaty as I remember. I'm never going to Subway again. For the money I've paid for that. You just weren't good enough. If you're gonna pay close to £5 for a sarnie, it needs to be a lot better than that. In fact, it was horrible. I didn't enjoy it. I do actually remember Subway being better than that. And I need to reiterate, I think I've said it now 6 times. Nought to do with this particular Subway, nought to do with him. The ingredients, the bread was overly sweet. And that's the same sandwich as what I would normally get. The tomato sauce was really thin, actually. The sauce, what the meatball marinara sauce was in. It did taste quite tomatoey, but it was very thin, very thin. I think the other customer was actually a Deliveroo person, and because they also do, they've got a Deliveroo, Uber Eats and Just Eat in the window, so they're trying to cover everybody. And yes, I want something else to eat now. Why did I have to make such a stupid rule for myself? There's a Mackie D's inside that ASDA. Why didn't I just say to myself, I'm never going to go eat at a Subway until I go back to work? Because then that would have been an easier thing to do. Because that was my... I think that was my third Subway in about 10 years. And I've got this aftertaste in my mouth that's not particularly good. Oh, home again, jiggity jig. See what I bought. There's a sign over there saying we are limiting numbers in store. Please keep a safe distance. Please shop solo if you can. All three lies, really, because the ASDA was incredibly busy. Nobody was limiting anything. Safe distance, yeah, whatever. It was that stupid coughing bloke. And please shop solo if you can. There were still entire families in there. Families of 6, 7 and 8. If you're going to put a sign like that outside your shop, ASDA, what am I talking about anyway? ASDA's adverts really suck at the minute as well, don't they? Anyway, I'm going to get the bus back. And I have a choice of three, but I don't know which one to get. It's a bank holiday, so I had to take into account that I had to look at the special signs. See when the buses are. Oh, that was bird poo. And it looks as if the chances are going to be either the 260 or the 440. Because the 487 is very sporadic. Whereas normally there'd be a bus every 5 minutes or something, or whatever. There isn't today. I'm sorry to keep banging on about that sandwich, but it's the only thing I've eaten today so far. And it's 12:30, I think. I don't know what time it is specifically. But that's the only thing I've eaten today, and it's disappointed me. Now, normally when you're really hungry, you'll eat anything, won't you? I'm regretting eating that. I'm really looking forward to eating something else.
Cheers, thank you.
It's actually nearly 2 o'clock. I don't know where I got 12:30 from. I'm now at North Acton Station. If I'd have got off at this station, I'd have been at ASDA in about 2 minutes.
North Acton Station.
Oh no. Decided to stop off at Sainsbury's and get another sandwich. Can't believe how quiet it is. It's a bank holiday. And alright, it's just after Christmas, but normally it will be heaving. I'm the only one upstairs. There's a mum and young daughter downstairs. But the real test is when it gets to the other side of Westfield. Because I'm gonna say if there's any fewer than 10 people waiting for this bus at the next bus stop, that shows you how deadly quiet it is. And that should say a lot as well, but the 207's empty upstairs as well. Very, very quiet. It's great though, because I get my window. I'm not on my usual seat though, because this bus is filthy. I think because this bus is getting old, I don't think they take as much care of it anymore. And it's just absolutely filthy. It could do with a good, clean. I mean, this is not from daily use. I'd say this is a good couple of days since it's been cleaned. It's not very good, is it? Looks as if there's nobody downstairs on the 207 in front of us. Yeah, depending on where you edit this down. Thanks for watching, please scratch. Because this is coming to the end of my recordings now. And, except for the very end where you'll see what I bought from ASDA. That was a lot that I'd spent at ASDA. I can't believe I'd spent that much. But that is all to cover future YouTube videos. Now I said fewer than 10, didn't I? Would say how quiet it is. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... There's 8 people getting on. 8. He's 9. That is so quiet. This station will be absolutely heaving. Let's remind myself and show you what I bought from ASDA. Which I spent £41.90. That is one of my biggest shops I've ever spent on so little. And...
We've got these. This one's Cajun quinoa micrograin, iron fibre source of protein. Yes, I know it's pronounced quinoa, but I like to call it quinoa, you know, because it's just keep it real. And, I mean, it's not flipping carnoir, is it? So why is it pronounced quinoa? Stupid. It's quinoa. Anyway. Fusilini. Fusilli, whatever it's called. micropasta. Source of fibre. Mmm. These look really delicious. This one's tomato and basil. If you're watching from the States, I know you pronounce it as basil, which I think is funny because you don't call basil from Fawlty Towers basil, do you? You call him basil. Or do you? Let me know in the comment section down below. I've got tomato and chorizo. Yeah, I think these are all 2 mins. That's what it says. You've got plenty of space to put minutes, but they put mins. Maybe it is because such convenience food, they're just trying to make it convenient for you to say it as quick as possible. Mixed grains and pulses. Shall we take its pulse? I can't feel anything. Terrible joke, that was horrific. This one's green pesto. I don't know why I bought that actually, because I don't like pesto. I found pesto is one of those things, like ginger or garlic, in the sense that if someone likes it, they tend to overdo it. Now, I love garlic, but I don't overdo the garlic. But you know, most people do though, don't they? Oh, we'll put some ginger in it and I'll flipping pour a full massive tub of it in. Or just chuck a full handful of ginger in it. Pesto's the same and all sorts. Anyway, barbecue beans and micrograin. Lovely. Yeah, they're about 2 minutes to cook. Oh, there's another one. This one's delicious lentils. I like it how they've got to say that this is delicious. I don't think they've done that for any of the other ones. No, they've not. But this is delicious lentils. Now, what's that implying? Is that implying that it's not actually delicious? And they're lying on the packaging? Or are they implying that all of lentils are disgusting? And these are delicious ones? We'll have to find out, won't we? Most of this stuff is going to be for review. But not all of it. What I've bought. Oh, no! I've bashed them up, haven't I? I've got some Tassimo Kenko Americano Grande. I know you say it's Grande, but it's not. It's Grande to me. I'm winding so many people up, probably. If I was watching myself and I wasn't myself, I'd probably be getting very cross right now. And I've got some gingerbread latte. Oh no, I've pronounced that wrong, haven't I? It's not latte, is it? For you... Just for you, Ryan Favre, it is latte, yes. There's another latte. Got to pronounce both the T's in latte now. Yorkshire tea malty biscuit. I did cover that in the earlier on in the video. I'm run out of space very quickly. This is bedtime decaf. With vanilla and nutmeg. I'm really intrigued to know these tastes. Actually, I've really bashed these up, actually. And I thought there was another one. Yes, there is. And this one is toast and jam. In a tea bag. Oh, flipping heck, I hope it is tea bags. Yes, it is tea bags. Otherwise, I'd have to buy a strainer because I do have a teapot, a very large teapot with a large spout. And a large handle. You have seen it if you're a subscriber. You've seen it at some point, hopefully. And I bought these crisps, didn't I? These turkey and stuffing and cooked crisps. We don't know if the turkey was stuffed by hand. But we'll try and fit that in the camera shot. There we go. I got some Seabrook's cream cheese and chav. Can't remember trying that one before. Now, I don't like cream cheese crisps generally, but every now and again, they're nice. I think I must have tried like so many brands of crisps with cream cheese flavour and disliked them. But sometimes it's really nice, and I don't know how sometimes it's horrible and sometimes it's nice. We'll just balance that on there like that. What else I got? Oh, I got some green giants. Oh, what's that sticker on there? Is this some of the food they got on a, they put on a plane and jetted over because of the lorry strikes? Not lorry strikes, the lorry jam that was in a lorry jam. That sounds like a tasty food, doesn't it? When all them lorries were stuck trying to get into Calais or whatever. I don't know. It can't be. Maybe that's, well, anyway, we'll put the... Is that green giant going to fit on there? Oof, only just. And then balancing that on there. I got this instant coffee, ASDA Smart Price. 70p this was. I'm going to see if you can get a really good tasty coffee for just... I wonder how much that is a spoon. How to prepare. They still put this on, really? Add 1 to 2 spoons of coffee to a cup or mug. Well, you might want to drink out of a vase. Add hot, but not boiling water and milk and sugar to taste. Really? Is that because that's all you're going to taste? We don't know. Very plain packaging because it's Smart Price. They used to be the fox. I don't know why ASDA got rid of the fox. It was like when ASDA Smart Price first came out, there was a little red fox as their little logo. And I thought that was quite cute. And you don't, they don't use it anymore. Is that going to stay on there or smash on the floor? I don't know. Oh yes, lots of bananas. Loads of bananas. How many bananas have I got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 bananas. Oh, it's like a kid's show, isn't it? Hello, children. How many bananas are there? 1. I ain't going to count. we'll get them on there like that. Are they going to stay on there like that? Just to get a bit of them in camera shot. There we go. It's one banana in camera shot. And I got these Branston baked beans with sausages. Now, I love Branston beans. They're the best baked beans you can get. Absolutely delicious. Lovely thick sauce. I just used to love sausage and baked beans in the same can. I'd be intrigued to know what the quality of the sausage is like. Where can I put these where they can be seen? Everything's falling off. Ah, there we go. Success. What else do we get? Oh, yeah. These was, I think, what was it? $3.50 or $3.99. I don't know if I'll check on the receipt in a minute. But these were actually reduced. There was an offer. And it's Lindt chocolate spread and Lindt hazelnut chocolate spread. This looks like it's going... What is the matter with me? I can talk, I swear. If you're a new subscriber or a new viewer, I can talk. These look as if they are in some sort of competition with Nutella. Looks very good, doesn't it? It better be as luxurious as it looks. I don't want them to fall off and break. Oh, he says as he nearly broke them. Where can I put these? I'm going to put them there like that. I'm trying to fill the screen as much as I can with stuff that I bought. I'm trying to make it look as if I bought more than I actually did. Because I'm not really that impressed with how little I've got for how much I spent, really. A bottle of stupid bleach. I made that joke already. It's not really a joke, it was just a fun thing to say. And lastly, but not leastly, there's my new box of Oreos. I suppose I should say that with a posh accent. New Oreo-os. There we go. There we go. Thanks for watching. Please grasp-bell me. Let me know in the comment section down below anything you want to know. Oh, by the way, them Lindt things were £3.50, marked down from £4.50.